Recorded praise is what I do. 3 years ago, we gathered together again in this place, and we recorded Shekinah Glory Live. And tonight, April 8th, 2007, we've gathered together again for another live recording of music of praise and worship. Somebody give God the glory. And this is exactly what this is. This is a gathering. The Bible talks about so often about what happens when people of God gather together with one spirit and one accord. The word of God tells us where two or three are gathered together in my name, he said, I would be in the midst. Psalms 133 talks about how good and pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity.
Amen.
We all remember Acts chapter 2 when 120 believers were gathered together in an upper room and Peter preached a sermon and 3,000 people got saved and the world has never been the same. Well, I want to tell you something's going to happen tonight in this place as we gather together for the third time. I never will forget that growing up as a PK, as a pastor's kid, I had seven brothers and sisters. And on an evening like this, Sunday nights, every Sunday night, all of my brothers and sisters, wherever they were, we would gather together at the Father's house.
Amen.
We would have fellowship.
Yes.
We would have food. But then we would get down on our knees and pray and worship God. And I just believe tonight that as we have come together in the Father's house,
in the Father's
house, together on this Resurrection Sunday night, that there's going to be some prayers that have gone through already, and there's going to be some praise and some worship.
Hallelujah.
But no matter what gathering you have been to, I'm here to tell you the best is yet to come. Because Revelation chapter 4 and 5 talks about a gathering around the throne.
My God.
John said, I saw a door open, and behold, there was a throne. And around the throne were four beasts, and they were flying around saying, holy, holy, holy. There were a number that no man can number from every kindred, tongue, and nation. And the one thing they consistently said was, worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy.
I believe that the power of God will come in here tonight in this gathering. If I had somebody help me say, worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy.
Somebody bless him tonight. This is a gathering. Say, worthy is the
Worthy.
Lamb. God, we give you the glory. God, we give you the praise. God, we give you your honor. And we pray that your anointing would be here tonight. Welcome to the live recording of Shekinah Glory on this Resurrection Sunday. Give God a praise in the house.
Hallelujah. I just wanted you all to have an opportunity to just bathe in the ministry of Apostle Wilson. He is one of the most phenomenal apostles within the land of Illinois that I used to attend their services. So I want to hear from you after we play the music. Please know that we do not own the rights to this music. It is for inspiration and promotion.
Everybody say, oh, 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 oh. Everybody say, oh, 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 oh. Everybody say, oh, 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 oh. Everybody say, oh, 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 oh.
Mighty warriors, people. Let's go to the word. We're going to get back with that. That's a really good song. My, my, my. It brings back a lot of good memories of times of personal fellowship. So tonight, we're going to speak a few moments about healing and the will of the Most High, the will of the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the will of the God of Israel, the will of the kingdom. Father, we just thank you and praise you. Yet another word going forth, Father. We do not take any of these opportunities for granted. Or we want to come to you and we want to bring a sacrifice of praise. We want to bring the fruit of our lips, Father. Father, let this word wash us deeper, 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 with yearning to be closer to you. We want your will to be done, and we're seeking you right now in the matchless name of Yeshua. We're going to give a brief introduction before we go into speaking about the will of the Father, you know, the will of God. That's so beautiful to know every one of the words we pronounce actually brings healing to us in spiritual and in physical. So the spiritual nature is where we're going to begin. I pray someone will be healed of the suffering of the resurrection. You know, I've learned a lot about how this works. With the end of sin is sickness and death. But then the gift of Yahweh is eternal life. So when we think about physical sickness, He has shown and revealed to me that physical sickness and we have sin in our life, it comes to the end, and then the sickness comes. But the sickness, and I always used to wonder why when people are sick, it seemed like you were in a holy place, you were in the sanctuary of life when we were, enduring a sickness at the time. But what I found out about that is that when the sickness comes, the opportunity before you are expired, you get the opportunity to repent. You get the opportunity to really have him work in your life. Oh, have I experienced that so many times. Have I experienced him working in my life, being everything I need, and he brought me back. But then what happens also is that we realize that we can't do anything and we come to the end of sin. And when he restores us, it's like a ownership, a branding. You know, he kind of puts us in a position where he has acknowledged that he accepts you. And you want to spend the rest of your life from that point on being in his will. So we're going to see here that the nature, the spiritual nature of sickness, so many people are coming with sickness, and not all sickness is the result of a person sinning necessarily, but sin is involved. Too long a wide distinction between sin and sickness has been made. It has been taught or taken for granted that the former must be dealt with from a spiritual point of view, while the latter, being purely physical, may be dealt with through natural means. That's a very important statement while we're on the subject of spiritual nature of sickness. Okay, so it says to us that However, more and more it is being recognized that sickness has a spiritual character. Then the reasonable understanding of a spiritual remedy, divine healing, will be established. The following three facts, which are a summary of what has been presented above, clearly, people of Yahweh, that establish the spiritual nature of physical sickness. Okay, this is a good subject. I don't want anybody to miss out because this is really a good subject. And then we're going to have some more Apostle Shekinah glory to come back to really wrap us in a beautiful melody of praise and worship. Okay, so let's go and kind of dive into this for a few moments. We're not going to stay very long, but want to introduce, these are major subjects and major matters that truly need to be explained and brought forth in this time where so much people are really needing to have faith to believe for the truth about the word. So then we pray for people that are sick. We're praying with the right understanding. We do that with the word of Yahweh, because he has designed his word that we may be healed. Amen. Okay, so it says, sickness is in the world because of sin. I hope you can hear me. Sickness is in the world.